So, dear student, today we are continuing the second chapter, Historiography, the Indian Tradition. So, today we are going to discuss about Bakhar. Actually, Bakhar is an important type of historical document of medieval times because it gives us information about the eulogies of the heroes, stories of historic events, battles, lives of great men. Means we can get the information about the contemporary heroes, their historical events, battles, and the lives of the great people through this Bakhar, and that's why Bakhar is a very important document of medieval times, which gives us historical information of the medieval time. If especially we are talking about the Marathi Bakhars, it has various types. Marathi Bakhars are of various types. Amongst the Marathi Bakhars, first Sabhasad Bakhar, which was written by Krishnaji Anant Sabhasad. Sabhasad Bakhar was written by Krishnaji Anant Sabhasad during the reign of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Chhatrapati Rajaram Maharaj. Chhatrapati Rajaram Maharaj ke reign mein, administration mein, Krishnaji Anant Sabhasad ne Sabhasad Bakhar likhi thi. Actually, this Sabhasad Bakhar contains the information about the rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Means, this Sabhasad Bakhar is very important historical document if we want to study the rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. And it was written in the Chhatrapati Rajaram Maharaj's reign, and that's why it is authentic. It is authentic. So, Sabhasad Bakhar, Krishnaji Anant Sabhasad was the writer. It was written during the Chhatrapati Rajaram Maharaj. Then it has the information about the rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Now let us talk about the another Bakhar, Bhau Sahibanchi Bakhar. Actually, Bhau Sahibanchi Bakhar describes the Battle of Panipat. Means the information about the Battle of Panipat is given in the Bhau Sahibanchi Bakhar. Another Bakhar is also there, Panipatchi Bakhar. This Bakhar also gives us information about the Battle of Panipat. Means, वहाँ पर दो ऐसी बखर से भाव साहिबांची बखर और पानीपतची बखर, दोनों बखर हमको पानीपत के बैटल के बारे में इंफॉर्मेशन देती हैं. So these two bakhars which give us information about the Battle of Panipat. Then another bakhar, होड़करांची कैफियत. होड़करांची कैफियत. This होड़करांची कैफियत, this bakhar provides us information about the Holkar's family and their contribution to the Maratha rule. So in this way, these are the four bakhars. Okay, here once again one wave chart can be asked or concept chart can be asked, the type of the various Marathi bakhars. Okay, Marathi bakhars, alag-alag Marathi bakhars kaun si hain. So wave chart can be asked us to for regarding this, it is also important. It is important. Apart from that, special question is asked on the Bakhars. Bakhar par ek special question bhi pucha jata hai for 2 marks, and that's why it is this topic is important. So at last, in the Bakhars can be divided into various types, such as biography. This is the categorization of the all the Bakhars, all kind of Bakhars. It is not about the Marathi Bakhars only. All type of Bakhars, all various different Bakhars can be divided into various types, such as categorization, biographies of kings, dynastic history, descriptions of events, history of sect, autobiography, then regarding grievances based on mythologies, and state administration by a king. Such type of different divisions, different categories could be in the Bakhars. So we can study this different type of Bakhars here. Now we are going to study historiography in the modern period. In the 20th century, the Indian archaeological exploration and research started under the British rule. History in the modern period, historiography in the modern period, if we are talking about the modern period, we should focus on that during this period, British had a rule on India. British were ruling over the India. So in the 20th century, the Indian Archaeological Exploration Research, okay, so during this period in the 20th century, all the Indian archaeological exploration and research started under the British rule. ये सब British rule में हुआ. Whatever the archaeological explorations means Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, जैसे excavation हुए, ये सब British rules में हुए. A number of ancient sites were excavated under the supervision of Sir Alexander Cunningham, the first Director General of the Archaeological Survey of India. Means it clearly is that Archaeological Survey of India was established by the Britishers. So a number of ancient sites were excavated under the supervision of the first Director General. This can be asked you for the match the pair or means the wrong pairs or the filling the blanks also. The first Director General of Archaeological Survey of India was Sir Alexander Cunningham. Okay, above on the page you have the picture of Sir Alexander Cunningham also. So many most of the number of ancient sites were excavated under the supervision of this Alexander Cunningham, who was the first Director General of Archaeological Survey of India. He chose mainly the sites mentioned in the Buddhist text, and he chose mainly the sites mentioned in the Buddhist text for this purpose. So for excavating the ancient sites, Alexander Cunningham chose mainly the sites mentioned in the Buddhist text for this purpose. So Buddhist text में जितने भी ancient sites को mention किया गया है, उन सारे sites को Sir Alexander Cunningham had chosen for the excavation to find out the ancient buildings or archaeological exploration to find out the history of India. He chose those sites which are mentioned in the Buddhist text. Harappan civilization was discovered during the tenure of Sir John Marshall. When Sir John Marshall was the Director General of Archaeological Survey of India, जब सर अलेक्जेंडर कनिंगहैम ही वाज़ द फर्स्ट डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ आर्कियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया, जिन्होंने इन्यूमरेबल एंशिएंट साइट्स को एक्सकैवेट किया एंड स्पेशली उन साइट्स को एक्सकैवेट किया जिन्हें बुद्धिस्ट टेक्स्ट में मेंशन किया गया है. सर जॉन मार्शल when he was the Director General of Archaeological Survey of India near about 1920-22, so during this period Harappan civilization was discovered. In the tenure of Sir John Marshall, Harappan civilization, the oldest civilization of India, oldest civilization of the world, Harappan civilization was discovered. Because of this discovery, the antiquity of Indian history could be traced to 3rd millennium BCE or even earlier. Because of this excavation, because of this discovery of Harappan civilization, the antiquity of Indian history, Indian history kitni purani hai, and ek antique hai, Indian history kitni old hai, ye प्रूव हो गया एंड इट वॉज ट्रेस टू द थर्ड मिलेनियम बीसी और इवन अर्लियर, मीन्स नियर अबाउट 5000 ईयर्स या उससे भी पुरानी, 3 मिलियन बीसीई, इतनी पुरानी ये इंडियन ट्रेडिशन है, इंडियन सिविलाइजेशन है, ये प्रूव हो गया. सो इन दिस वे हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन वॉज डिस्कवर्ड बाय सर जॉन मार्शल. ओके, सो इन दिस वे see, this is the picture of Sir Alexander Cunningham, and this is the picture of Sir John Marshall. Many British officials in India wrote about Indian history Their writings display strong influence of the colonial policies of the British. During the British rule, many British officials in India wrote about Indian history. And that's why during, because of these discoveries of ancient sites, so many British officials who came to India during that British administration, they wrote about the Indian history. But their writing clearly shows us the strong influence of colonial policies of the British. लेकिन उनकी जो writings है वो हमें clearly दिखाती है कि उन पर colonial policies की, British की colonial policies की influence था, उन पर प्रभाव था, ये हमें clearly पता चलता है. Three volumes of the history of British India written by James Mill. So this James Mill wrote three volumes of the history of British India. They were published in 1817. So these are the wrong pairs के लिए पूछा जा सकता है writer's name and the name of the book. So this was published in 1817 में ये पब्लिश किया गया था. This was the first book on Indian history written by the British historian. So one more filling the blank can be created here. The first book on Indian history written by a British historian was the History of British India. Okay, so the History of British India was the first book which on the Indian history which was written by the British historian, Oriental historiography, afterward we will study. So you can utilize these points also for the Oriental historiography. So it clearly reflects an absence of the objective perspective and prejudice about various aspects of the Indian culture. If we read this book, The History of British India, which was the first historical book on the Indian history which was written by British historian, when we read this book it clearly reflects हमें पता चलता है जब हम अगर ये बुक पढ़ते हैं द हिस्ट्री ऑफ ब्रिटिश इंडिया जो जेम्स मिल ने लिखी थी. सो हमें क्लियरली पता चलता है दैट दिस एब्सेंस ऑफ दैट रिफ्लेक्ट्स द एब्सेंस ऑफ ऑब्जेक्टिव पर्सपेक्टिव and prejudice about the various aspect of Indian culture. Objective perspective nahi tha usme. While writing this historical book, they have lack of objective perspective, objective attitude, objective viewpoint, and they had lot of misconceptions. They have lot of misconceptions about the various aspect of the Indian culture. Indian culture के बारे में उनको बहुत सारी गलत फहमियाँ थी, बहुत सारे misunderstandings थी, objective perspective यानी view point नहीं था उनके writing में. ये हमें if we write this the book historical books which were written by the Britishers, British officials, British scholars, especially the history of British India by James Mill. So we find these things, these demerits in the book. The History of India written by another book, okay? The History of India written by the Mountstuart Elphinstone, Governor of Mumbai, Governor of Bombay, now it is called Mumbai, was published in 1841. So afterward, another book which was written by the British officials, The History of India, okay, The History of British India was published in 1817, that was written by James Mill. Now only the History of India is there. There was British and India, this is British India and British, only India. This is the difference in the title of these books. So the History of India book was written by Mountstuart Elphinstone, the then governor of Bombay. तब के 1841 में ये बुक पब्लिश हुई थी और तब के गवर्नर, बॉम्बे के गवर्नर माउंटस्टुअर्ट एल्फिंस्टन ने ये बुक लिखी थी. द पीरियड ऑफ मराठा एम्पायर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द इंडियन हिस्ट्री. द पीरियड ऑफ मराठा एम्पायर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द इंडियन हिस्ट्री. इंडियन हिस्ट्री में मराठा एम्पायर का जो जो पीरियड है, इट वॉज अ गोल्डन पीरियड. सो इट वॉज वेरी, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द इंडियन हिस्ट्री. इंडियन हिस्ट्री में बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. ग्रैंड डफ नेम स्टैंड्स आउट अमॉन्ग द ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर्स हु रोट अबाउट मराठा हिस्ट्री. सो ग्रैंड डफ वॉज अ ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर्स स्पेशली हु रोट अबाउट द मराठा हिस्ट्री. ही वॉज द स्पेशली मेन्शन author or he was the historian, okay, British officer who wrote about the Maratha history. Who wrote the Maratha history? Grant Duff. Grant Duff's name stands out among the British officers who wrote the Maratha history. He wrote the book entitled A History of Marathas. Which book did he write? Grant Duff, A History of Marathas. This book is published in 3 volumes. The History of Marathas was published in 3 volumes. Okay, and Grant Duff was the British officer who wrote about the Maratha history. This book is published in 3 volumes. Grant Duff's writing also shows the British inclination of condemning Indian culture and history. Here, if we analyze the Grant Duff's book, A History of Marathas, about the Maratha history, so we will find the same thing which we found in James Mill's book or the Mountstuart Elphinstone's book. That is the inclination of condemning Indian culture and history, prejudice about the Indian culture, okay, and history. So यहाँ पर भी हमें वही बात दिखाई देती है that James Mill या माउंट स्टुअर्ट एल्फिंस्टन इनकी बुक्स में सिमिलरली ग्रैंड डफ की हिस्ट्री ऑफ मराठास इसमें भी हमें वही दिखाई देता है कि दे हैड द प्रेजुडाइज एंड दे कंडेम दे क्रिटिसाइज द इंडियन कल्चर एंड हिस्ट्री. दे डिड नॉट अप्रिशिएट द इंडियन कल्चर एंड हिस्ट्री कभी उन्होंने बिकॉज दे हैड द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द कॉलोनियल ब्रिटिश रूल. ओके, उनके ऊपर कॉलोनियल ब्रिटिश रूल का इम्पैक्ट था एंड दैट्स वाई दे कंडेम द इंडियन कल्चर एंड हिस्ट्री. सिमिलर टेंडेंसी इज विटनेस इन कॉलोनियल कर्नल टॉड्स राइटिंग अबाउट राजस्थान हिस्ट्री. Another example is also there that can prove that really they had an impact of the colonial British rule and misunderstandings about the Indian culture and history, lack of the objective perspective that Colonel Todd's writing about Rajasthan's history. Colonel Todd wrote the Rajasthan's history. Similar thing is seen in his book also. The two volumes written by William Wilson Hunter, two volumes written by William Wilson Hunter on Indian history shows a somewhat impartial treatment of the subject. But William Wilson Hunter, who has written on Indian history, somewhere a little impartial treatment has been given by this British officer. In British officer ne thoda sa impartial treatment yahan par as a historian Indian history ke saath mein kiya hai. Among Indian historians, Nilkanth Janardhan Kirtane and Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade, V.K. Rajwade, okay. So these two Indian historians were the two Indian historians who took upon the task of exposing the limitations of Grant Duff's history. So these two historians, Nilkanth Janardhan Kirtane and Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade, you can pick up this point while talking about writing about the V.K. Rajwade. Okay, so Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade, these two historians, Indian historians, were there that they exposed the limitations of Grant Duff's writing. Grant Duff ki writing mein kya limitations they, what prejudice was there about the Indian culture, what lack of the objective perspective, wo sari cheeze inhone expose ki. So Indian historiography various ideological frameworks means Indian historiography had a great impact of various ideology. इंडियन हिस्टोग्राफी में अलग अलग आइडियोलॉजी का इम्पैक्ट पड़ा हुआ है एंड दैट्स व्हाई अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट आइडियोलॉजीज वेरियस historians have written according as in that a particular ideological framework. So first of all, we are talking about the colonial historiography. Colonial historiography, as we have seen now, just now we have studied about the Grand Duke, James Mill, Mountstuart, and then Colonel Todd. Okay, they also belong to the colonial historiography. ये भी colonial historiography में भी आते हैं. Okay, so the early scholars who studied and wrote Indian history were mainly British officers and Christian missionaries. So the early scholars who studied and wrote about the Indian history, they were largely British officers, either British officers or the Christian missionaries. Means Indian history के बारे में सबसे पहले लिखने वाले जो scholars थे वो एक तो British officer थे या Christian missionaries थे. इन्होंने ही Indian history के बारे में लिखा. Their prejudice is clearly reflected in the way some of them have ridiculed Indian culture. उनका prejudice about the Indian culture, their prejudice about the Indian culture is clearly seen in the way through which they have ridiculed the Indian culture. जिस तरह से उन्होंने Indian culture का ridicule किया है, उससे हमें उनका कितना what misunderstanding they had about the Indian culture हमको पता चल जाता है. So in the colonial historiography the scholars had the prejudice about the Indian culture के बारे में उनमें prejudice थे, misunderstanding थे, they did not know the Indian culture. Their writings were used to justify the colonial British rule, and that's why their writings, because they had a great impact of the colonial British rule. इन पर बहुत ज़्यादा colonial British rule का impact था, imperialism, imperialistic nature of the British rule, ये impact उनके ऊपर था, and that's why we can use their writings to justify the colonial British rule. हम colonial British rule को justify करने के लिए, उसे study करने के लिए, हम इन colonial historiography की books का use कर सकते हैं, उनकी writings का book use कर सकते हैं. The five volume of Cambridge History of India, published during 1922 to 1937 CE. So, five volumes of this book, Cambridge History of India, were published. Five volumes were published during the period of 1922 to 1937 CE. Okay, are the distinct examples of the colonial historiography. So, this Cambridge History of India has five volumes which are the best examples of the colonial historiography. Another ideology is the Orientalist historiography. Earlier I told you that Oriental historiography, actually they James Mill and all, they were belonging to the colonial historiography. Okay, so Orientalist historiography, let us understand what is Oriental, yani Europe. Oriental means Europe होता है, okay? So Orientalist historiography, many European scholars felt curious about civilization and countries of the East. So many European scholars were very curious. They felt curious. उनको बहुत curiosity feel होती थी about the civilization and countries of the East, specially about India. Indian civilization के बारे में बहुत ज़्यादा curiosity European scholars को हुआ करती थी. Some of those scholars felt admiration and respect for them. और see, if we study colonial and orientalist historiography, there is a little difference, okay? Colonial historiography had the great impact of the colonial British rule. But Oriental historiographers, these European scholars who felt curious about the Indian civilization and means the civilization and countries of the East. So this is the difference. They had an admiration and respect for these civilizations. So Eastern countries ki civilizations or countries ke liye unme respect tha. They did not have, colonial walo ko koi respect nahi tha. They had the impact of the colonial British rule. Okay, these scholars were known as Orientalist. In scholars who, the scholars who felt curious about the Eastern civilization and countries, they had the admiration and respect for them. they were known as Orientalists. The Orientalists studied the similarities between Sanskrit and some of the European language. So, what did they study? Orientalists studied the similarities between the Sanskrit language and the other European languages. कुछ यूरोपियन लैंग्वेजेस के सम ऑफ द यूरोपियन लैंग्वेजेस और संस्कृत में क्या सिमिलरिटीज है वो इन्होंने स्टडी किया. दे फोकस मोर ऑन वैदिक ट्रेडिशन एंड संस्कृत लिटरेचर एंड दैट्स व्हाई दे हैड ऑलवेज द अट्रैक्शन टू अबाउट द इंडियन कल्चर और द ईस्टर्न कल्चर एंड दैट्स व्हाई दे फोकस देयर स्टडीज ऑन द वैदिक ट्रेडिशन एंड संस्कृत लिटरेचर. संस्कृत लिटरेचर वैदिक ट्रेडिशन पर ही अपनी स्टडी के लिए उन्होंने फोकस किया. Their studies resulted into formulating the notion of an ancient language that could be the mother of all Indo-European language. Because of the study of the Orientalist, it formulated the view that an ancient language, okay, means the Sanskrit, that could be the mother of all Indo-European languages. Means this view came forward because of the study of these Orientalists. This view came forward that Sanskrit could be the mother of all Indo-European language. So among the Orientalist historiographers, in 1784, Sir William Jones founded Asiatic Society in Kolkata. So this is also asked for the wrong pair. Okay, Sir William Jones founded Asiatic Society in Kolkata. Because of this Asiatic Society, it opened the doors for research in ancient Indian literature and history. So because of this Asiatic Society in Kolkata, because of that it opened the doors for research in ancient India and Indian literature and history. So Asiatic Society in Kolkata mein open hone ki wajah se India historians ko ek scope mil gaya that they could study, they could research the ancient Indian literature and history. In ancient Indian literature or history में scholars research कर सके because of the Asiatic Society in Kolkata, which was founded by Sir William Jones in 1784. Among the Orientalist scholars, Frederick Max Muller deserves a special mention. Frederick Max Muller deserved the special mentions. Among the Orientalist scholars, Frederick Max Muller deserved the special mention. Why? Okay, why? Why he deserved the special mention, Frederick Max Muller? See, why? Its reason is here. In his opinion, Sanskrit was the most ancient language of the Indo-European languages. According to Frederick Max Muller, he believed that Sanskrit was the most ancient language of the Indo-European languages. Indo-European languages mein Sanskrit language ye sabse purani language hai, aisa wo mante the. And that's why he had a deep interest in Sanskrit literature. Aur isiliye unhe Sanskrit literature mein bahut zyada interest tha. He translated the Sanskrit text of Hitopadesh. He first translated the Sanskrit text of Hitopadesh. He was the editor of 50 volumes of the Sacred Book of the East. So he first, सबसे पहले उन्होंने संस्कृत टेक्स्ट हितोपदेश को ट्रांसलेट किया. Then Frederick Max Muller was the editor of 50 volumes, 50 books he published. The Sacred Book of the East. Okay, इस बुक के वो एडिटर थे जिसके 50 volumes पब्लिश किए गए, named the Sacred Book of the East. Again, Frederick Max Muller, the Sacred Book of the East. He also compiled Rigveda. he had so deep interest in Sanskrit that he's translated the Sanskrit text of Hitopadesh. Then he compiled Rigveda, which has been published in 6 volumes. उन्होंने ऋग्वेद को भी compile किया, ऋग्वेद को भी compile करके उसे 6 volumes में publish किया. He translated Rigveda in German और उन्होंने ऋग्वेदा को जर्मन लैंग्वेज में ट्रांसलेट किया एंड ही कंपाइल्ड इट इन 6 books एंड ही पब्लिश्ड देम. लेटली एडवर्ड सेड एंडिंग में हम वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द एडवर्ड सेड. इट इज द नेम ऑफ द स्कॉलर एडवर्ड सेड, अ स्कॉलर हु हैज रीइवैल्यूएटेड द ओरिएंटलिस्ट राइटिंग्स. ओके, एडवर्ड सेड re-evaluated the Orientalist writings. He studied the Orientalist writings. उन्होंने Orientalist writings की study की and has thrown light on imperialistic interest of Orientalist scholars. Actually, Edward said again exposed the Orientalist writing historians over here as the colonial historiographers. They had a great impact of the colonial British rule. So similarly, the Orientalist historiographer had the impact of the imperialism, imperialistic nature of the European countries. Okay, ये imperialistic interest था उनको और oriental means imperialistic interest क्यों था? If they could understand the literature, they could understand the civilization, culture of the Eastern countries, they could imperialize, they could come over there and they establish their colonies over there. So this nature, imperialistic interest is seen through the book of Orientalist scholars and that has been exposed by Edward Said. So nationalistic historiography. You know, when Britishers came to India, Britishers wanted the administrative manpower or administrative group in India because they could not bring all the Britishers over here and they create the administration, they look after the administration. And with this purpose, they wanted the administrative group here and that's why they gave Western education to Indian people. Indian logo ko kya karne lage, wo education dene lage. So let us continue now, see kya hua uski wajah se. The writings of the Indian historians who were trained in the British educational system show an inclination to restore the pride in the ancient glory of India. So those Indian historians, those Indian scholars who studied, who were trained in the British educational system, they were introduced with the country, nationalism, freedom, liberty, such concept. They were introduced with such concepts through the British educational system. Is British educational system se unko in concepts, in ideas ka pata chala. And that's why they realized they wanted to restore the pride in the ancient glory of India and the self-esteem of the Indian readers. They studied the Orientalist historiographer, they studied the colonial historiographer, and that's why they found out the imperialistic nature of the Orientalist historiographer, then impact of the British rule on the colonial historiographer, misunderstanding about the Indian history and culture. So that's why they wanted to restore, bring back, revive the pride in the Indian ancient glory of India. India ki ancient glory ko ka jo pride tha, usse dobara wo lana chahte the, and self-esteem of the Indian readers. And that's why when the Indians will read their own history, they should feel pride and self-respect. ओके, तो इंडियन रीडर्स को सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट वापस देने के लिए, अपने इंडिया हिस्ट्री की के लिए प्राइड फील होना चाहिए, ये वापस लाने के लिए इंडियन हिस्टोरियंस जो ब्रिटिश एजुकेशनल सिस्टम में जिन्होंने जो ट्रेन बने, दे राइटिंग ऑफ दीज ब्रिटिश हिस्टोरियंस वॉर इंडियन हिस्टोरियंस वॉज इज नोन एज द नेशनलिस्टिक हिस्टोग्राफी. सो देयर राइटिंग्स आर नोन एज नेशनलिस्टिक हिस्टोग्राफी, मीन्स द राइटिंग ऑफ द इंडियन हिस्टोरियंस, इंडियन हिस्टोरियंस की राइटिंग्स को नेशनलिस्टिक हिस्टोग्राफी कहा जाता है. दोज हिस्टोरियंस स्टडीड और ट्रेन अंडर द ब्रिटिश एजुकेशनल सिस्टम एंड दे वॉन्टेड दे शो एन इंक्लिनेशन, दे शोड देयर इंटरेस्ट टू रिस्टोर द प्राइड इन द एंशियंट ग्लोरी ऑफ इंडिया एंड द सेल्फ एस्टीम ऑफ द इंडियन रीडर. ये वापस लाना चाहते थे और उन ब्रिटिश उन इंडियन हिस्टोरियंस की राइटिंग्स को ही नेशनलिस्टिक हिस्टोग्राफी कहा जाता है. सो नेशनलिस्टिक हिस्टोग्राफी, नेशनलिस्टिक राइटिंग्स इन महाराष्ट्र, स्पेशली वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट महाराष्ट्र नाउ, नेशनलिस्टिक राइटिंग इन महाराष्ट्र वेर इंस्पायर्ड बाय विष्णु शास्त्री चिपळूणकर. दिस इज द इंपॉर्टेंट नेम, ओके, विष्णु शास्त्री चिपळूणकर. सो नेशनलिस्टिक राइटिंग्स इन महाराष्ट्र वेर ग्रेटली इंस्पायर्ड बाय विष्णु शास्त्री चिपळूणकर. महाराष्ट्र की नेशनलिस्टिक राइटिंग विष्णु शास्त्री चिपळूणकर से प्रभावित थी. ही क्रिटिसाइज द प्रिजुडाइज्ड हिस्ट्री ऑफ एंशियंट इंडिया रिटन बाय ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर्स. As we have earlier studied colonial historiography, orientalist historiography, they had the prejudice about the Indian culture and history. So they criticize, Vishnu Shastri Chipळूणकर criticized this prejudice about the history of ancient India written by the British officers. British officer ने जो history लिखी थी India की, जिसमें Indian history के बारे में जो prejudice उनका था, उसको उन्होंने बहुत ज़्यादा criticize किया. The nationalistic historians tried to seek the golden era of Indian history and thus by criticizing, by removing the misunderstandings about the Indian culture and history, these nationalistic historians tried to bring back, revive the golden era of the Indian history. Indian history ke golden era ko wapas paane ki koshish nationalistic historiographers ne. They are at times blamed for ignoring the critical analysis of the historical truth. And that's why they criticize the prejudiced history of ancient India written by the British officers. At the same time, they blame them for ignoring the critical analysis of the historical truth. Because modern historiography believes that critical analysis hona chahiye. Okay, critical analysis of historical documents should be done, but that was not done by the British officers. Ye unhone nahi kiya tha about the Indian history. So they blame for ignoring the critical analysis of the historical truth. Mahadev Govind Ranade, Ramkrishna Gopal Bhandarkar, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, Rajendra Lal Mishra, then Ramesh Chandra Mazumdar, काशी प्रसाद जायसवाल, राधा कुमुद मुखर्जी, भगवान लाल इंद्रजी, वासुदेव विष्णु मीराशी एंड अनंत सदाशिव आलतेकर आर द नेम ऑफ सम रिनोन्ड स्कॉलर्स अमंग द नेशनलिस्टिक हिस्टोरियंस. सो यू हैव टू लर्न दीज, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दीज नेम्स, बिकॉज वंस अगेन द कंसेप्ट चार्ट इज आस्क्ड ओवर देयर कि द हिस्टो नेम ऑफ द हिस्टोरियंस मीन्स द nationalistic historians. Okay, Justice Mahadev Govind Ranade has explained the background of the rise of Maratha Empire in the great details, in great details in his book. Justice Govind Ranade, Mahadev Govind Ranade, he has explained the background of the rise of Maratha Empire in detail, the rise of Maratha power. डिटेल में उन्होंने द राइज ऑफ मराठा पावर इन दिस बुक महादेव गोविंद रानडे, जस्टिस महादेव गोविंद रानडे हैज एक्सप्लेन द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द राइज ऑफ द मराठा पावर, मींस व्हाई द मराठा पावर केम इनटू बीइंग, व्हाई द मराठा पावर राइज. सो दिस बैकग्राउंड हैज बीन गिवन इन दिस, इन हिज बुक द राइज ऑफ मराठा पावर. According to him, it was not like a suddenly erupted forest fire, but the ground for it in Maharashtra on the social, cultural and religious level was getting ready over a prolonged period. According to him, according to Justice Mahadev Govind Ranade, Maratha power was not just like a forest fire, suddenly erupted forest fire, but for this, on the social, cultural and religious level, there was a ground was created, and then for a long period it was created, and then this Maratha Empire was established. It was not a sudden eruption of the forest fire. एकदम से लगने वाली जंगल में जैसे आग लग जाती, Maratha power was did not rise in this way. So, उसके लिए एक बैकग्राउंड क्रिएट किया गया सोशल कल्चरल रिलीजियस लेवल पर, एंड देन दिस मराठा पावर. सो रजवाड़े, जस्ट थोड़े देर पहले हमने वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द रजवाड़े. ओके, कॉलोनियल हिस्टोग्राफी के ऊपर के पैराग्राफ में हमने रजवाड़े को पढ़ा था. Rajwade is well known for his writings in Marathi on various subjects like history, linguistics, etymology, grammar, etc. Rajwade is well known, he is very popular for his writings in Marathi. Marathi mein likhne ke liye Rajwade, V.K. Rajwade bahut zyada famous hai. He has written on various subjects like history, linguistics, etymology, grammar, ऐसे बहुत सारे subjects में उन्होंने लिखा है. He had a deep knowledge, he had compact knowledge, profound knowledge about the various subjects, and he has written on the subjects like history, linguistics, etymology and grammar. So he is popular for his writings in Marathi. He was of the firm opinion that we should write our own history. वो इस ओपिनियन के थे, he strongly believed that we have to write, we should write our own history. हमने हमारी हिस्ट्री लिखनी चाहिए. ब्रिटिशर्स और somebody else do not have the right to write our about us, है ना, because we know ourselves better than them, है ना, हम अपने आप को अच्छी तरह से जानते हैं, है ना. सो वी शुड राइट आवर ओन हिस्ट्री, हमने हमारी खुद की हिस्ट्री हमने लिखनी चाहिए. ही कंपाइल्ड एंड एडिटेड 22 वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ मराठांच्या इतिहासाची साधने. सो ही कंपाइल्ड एंड एडिटेड 20 वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ द बुक मराठांच्या इतिहासाची साधने. इस बुक के 22 वॉल्यूम्स को उन्होंने कंपाइल किया, बनाया एंड एडिट भी किया. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट वी के रजवाड़े मराठांच्या इतिहासाची साधने. ही रोट वेरी स्कॉलरली प्रीफेस टू ईच ऑफ द 22 वॉल्यूम्स, एंड ही रोट द प्रीफेस ऑफ ईच 22 वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ मराठांच्या इतिहासाची साधने वेरी क्लेवरली ही रोट देम. बहुत ही स्कॉलरली, बहुत ही क्लेवरली उन्होंने उस फर्स्ट पेज को इन बुक, इन 22 वॉल्यूम्स के फर्स्ट बुक को, फर्स्ट पेज को लिखा है. स्टेटेड, वो कहते हैं, हिस्ट्री इज द ऑल इंक्लूसिव इमेज ऑफ द पास्ट सोसाइटीज. हिस्ट्री इज द ऑल इंक्लूसिव मीन्स हिस्ट्री कवर्स ऑल द एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द पास्ट सोसाइटीज. पास्ट सोसाइटीज के सारे एस्पेक्ट को कवर करती है. It does not include only the stories of political image. See, political image, conspiracies, war or for seizing power, इनको ही वो include नहीं करती है. Okay? But it include all the aspects of the human life, all the aspects of the past societies. सभी चीजें वो cover करती है, उनमें होनी चाहिए, ऐसा वो कहते हैं. Means, according to V.K. Rajwade, history is all-inclusive image of the past societies. It does not focus only the political image or conspiracies or their wars. He insisted that history should be written only using authentic documentary sources. और वो ये भी इस बात को भी stress करते हैं that history must be written using the authentic documentary resources. Means history must be written using the authentic documents. Historical documents ऑथेंटिक होने चाहिए, दे मस्ट बी ऑथेंटिक एंड यूजिंग दीज ऑथेंटिक डॉक्यूमेंट्स वी हैव टू राइट द हिस्ट्री. दिस इज द स्टेटमेंट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द गिवन रीजन और आंसर फॉर 2 marks. The nationalistic historiography helped in triggering of the independence movement of the Indian people against British. Okay, this statement is important. So, nationalistic historiography helped to induce, to accelerate the independence movement of the Indian people against the British. Historiography, nationalist historiography की वजह से Indian movement जो थी Britishers के against में, उसको और ज़्यादा power आ गया, और ज़्यादा forcefully वो हो गई, बहुत पावर से वो की गई, उसमें और एक्साइटमेंट आ गया. सो इन दिस एस्पेक्ट द बुक, सो इसके लिए बिकॉज वी कैन कंसीडर ऑल द नेशनलिस्टिक हिस्टोग्राफर्स दैट वी के रजवाड़े टोल्ड द पीपल दैट वी हैव टू राइट आवर ओन हिस्ट्री, हमने हमारी खुद की हिस्ट्रीज लिखनी चाहिए, राइट. ये दिस दिस इंक्लूस दिस इनकरेजेस द पीपल to write about their own history. No? Yes, we have to write about own history. V.K. Rajwade, I told you that point, V.K. Rajwade removed the grand ups, okay? He exposed the grand ups, that deficiencies in his writing. So, we have to take that point also. So, in this way, in this respect, and another point is there here, that the Indian War of Independence 1857 written by Vinayak Damodar Savarkar is of great importance. Aur iske liye sabse importance for this in triggering the independence movement, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar's book, The War of Indian War of Independence 1857, first national uprising of India, okay, so it had a great importance. Because of that, it really encourages the people. The nationalistic historiography provided a momentum to the writing of regional historiography too. This statement is also important. Question can be asked on this statement also. The nationalistic historiography provided a momentum to the writing of nationalistic histories too. Because of these, दे इंस्पायर द पीपल, दे इंस्पायर द स्कॉलर, है ना, उन्होंने इंस्पायर कर दिया कि नहीं, हमने हमारी हिस्ट्री खुद लिखनी चाहिए, राइट. सो दीज नेशनल, बिकॉज ऑफ नेशनलिस्टिक हिस्टोग्राफी द पीपल एनकरेज दैट प्रोवाइडेड अ मोमेंटम टू द राइटिंग ऑफ रीजनल हिस्टोग्राफी एंड दैट्स वाई बिकॉज ऑफ द नेशनलिस्टिक हिस्टोग्राफीज मेनी स्कॉलर्स रीजनल स्कॉलर्स एनकरेज एंड दे स्टार्टेड टू राइट देयर ओन हिस्ट्रीज मीन्स द रीजनल हिस्ट्रीज को मोमेंटम मिला, रीजनल हिस्ट्रीज भी लिखी जाने लगी. एज अ रिजल्ट द अटेंशन ऑफ द हिस्टोरियन वॉज ड्रॉन टू द जोग्राफिक कंडीशन एंड हिस्ट्री ऑफ साउथ इंडियन. As a result, because परिणाम था क्या हो गया, attention of the historians was drawn to the geographic conditions. Geographic conditions कैसी है, बाकी history कैसी है, especially the South Indian regions की history क्या है, इनके तरफ लोगों का attention खींचा गया. So thank you, I stop here for today. Thank you very much. Keep watching my channel, subscribe it, press the bell icon, and don't forget to give me like and share more and more to your friends so that they should also get the help of my videos. Thank you.